Welcome back. This is Nana, and we are into the next day's session on e-business essentials of artwork. Fine, you go there, and then you're going ahead on this now. So let's go there and then see this now. So I'll go there. Operations, not operations. We have already logged in. In A1 underscore user, isn't it? A1 underscore user 1. And then welcome is the password. I'll go on and see whether I have logged in or not. Yes, no, we're not there. Okay, we'll now go on then. I have forgotten the passwords, operations, and then welcome. Let me go on and see my credentials of logging in actually. So, yeah, I'm going to accept the events and then go into the navigator now. And then let us go to sysadmin and then let me query my username and password. I might have created only one user, I think, probably, because I'm not getting much of users as such. No? Let me go and reset the passwords. If I'm not exactly remembering the password, I'll now reset the passwords and then come back and then I'll log in now. This is a gap.
சார் எல்லாத்துக்கும் காலைல சுத்தறி புத்தகம் பண்ணிக்க கூடாது இருக்கு.
Right, okay, man. Now what happens if you're now going to this place? Let me go to sysadmin and then what happens? I go, we'll now have a look at the passwords now. Let me change the passwords. Yeah, and the document allowed the inventory. And my fusion inventory gets in on the particular thing. What was there? What was there? What is sysadmin now? Press yes, everything starting and this will be coming. Control end will now take you to the last one, which is system administrator. Resume it. Fine, go there. And then here, you go to security user defined. Yes, enter. The navigation, which whatever they can go to security user defined as a distinct password, and then go there, query. And then A1 percentage, and then let me query it now. So I'm going to query it. So A1 percentage, and then query it. What is the this thing I have given here? Huh? What I have given? A1 user 1 or what? A1 VMA1 is there. AMA cons is there. What is the thing you are given here? Is it Yamal Yarma? Hey, what is the
A1 underscore implementation user?
A1 so we have to go on and see that record now. End up on anything. 01 underscore user one. Right? What is 01? Fine, go there. Go to the
percentage.
01 percentage. So we are having this now. 01 user one. Fine, what is fine. Close it. So I think I will go again only welcome. Fine. Exit out of portal applications. Alt-fx. Alt-fx is common for Word, Excel, PowerPoint, whatever it is, fine, Alt-F-X, and then come out of it, Alt-F, and then X, fine, and then go there and then do it, Alt-F-X, what is it? So we have identified the username now, fine, it is 01 underscore user 1, 01 underscore user 1, fine, and the password is welcome, welcome is the password, click on login now. So we are now logging in, and then we are going to the home page, clear on this, add to favorites, let me add to the favorites first of all. Add to the favorites. And then I will now choose the responsibility of 01 responsibility and then give it out. One of them I will be adding it to the favorites now. If I click on go, it will not show me this thing. All the functions it will not show. One of them I will be adding it to the favorites. So that what happens from there, I can directly go on them, click on it so that we can land up on the main page over here. Right? So enter journal 01, I will now select it and then click on add to favorites now. So one of them I'm adding it to favorites. It gets added up over here now. I click on apply. By which what happens, it will be getting applied. So this is a very easy way of doing it now. Go down, say this one. So at the favorites is not done. Click on apply and then this gets applied. Right? Apply it now. So click on apply. So you can now see this on the favorites. On the favorites screen. So you can now see at the bottom waiting is coming. So once when this is completed, so you will now click on the favorites now. The favorites. Navigator is coming. The star is a favorites. Star is a favorites. So click on it, you've got the enter address channel, so I click on it and then you'll now land up on the home page. We will now come to the navigator screen. So from the navigator screen, what happens, we are now going to create the complete enterprise structure now. So the enterprise structure comprises of this now. So we now go on and create the business group first, the first activity is a business group. So 01 business group is the one which I'm going to create now. So let me create the business group and then afterwards come over here now. So we go there and see this now. So, entity, Yeah, enterprise will be having a business group at the top, a ledger, a legal entity, an operating unit, a master org, and then a child org. And there are six elements of it, and then there may be multiples of all these elements actually in the structure. So typically speaking, what happens, you'll be having only one item master, and then you'll have only what, this is the only one which will be having one, the remaining can be many, even business group will be one. The business group and then the master will be only one each, whereas the remaining can be many as such in the structure. So this is what else. And then let me go and create this and then show it to you. Go there and say this now come wire, close it. Then let us go there and then we will now go to what? Close it. And then I have logged in as this my go to inventory. And then go to setups now. Press yes. And then go to what happens? You go to organization, press go. And then here you go to organization. Yes, go enter will now take you to the navigation now. Yes, and then go and then enter. Fine, click on new now. New is alt A. Alt A is new. Fine, what else? And then here what happens? 01 underscore business. Business group is the one. So the type is what, you drop it down and then learn it. Now find this is normally what happens, it will be area headquarters or the corporate headquarters. It will be a corporate headquarters. It doesn't have any functionality, it's only thing. So you already create the location, fine, you tap. All the employees of this are internal now, fine, save it now. Now upon saving, you can see in the bottom message that it is now created now. Business group is now created. Yeah. So you can now see the transaction complete is coming, only hop is coming. If you click on the center button, you'll be able to see full, fine. Mandichi. And click on it. Now I'm going to classify this as a business group now, BUSI, and then give it a tap. So business group is a classification which I'm going to give it. And then enable the classification and then commit. Fine, then press commit. It's not done. I go to others and then we are going to give this. Fine, click on this. So we are going to classify the other activities on this now. Fine. So click on others button and then provide all the information now. So this will be done with HR team actually. But since HR is not there, we go to the business group information, click on OK. You're going to go there and then go hard and then click enter now. It comes over here. I'm going to give a short name for this now. Fine. The 01 underscore BG1. And then employee number generation is automatic. This is automatic. And then this is also automatic. Press A and then give a tap. Grade is grade. My grade is grade. This will be given by the HRMS team. Job is job. And then what happens? Position is position. POSI and then give a tap and then choose the position. Once and you give half, and then there will be a what is my list of value icons is coming. So choose the fine. The remaining. Or different now. The three flux fields are same. Grade is what? Group is what? People group. P-O-P-L-E. People group. You're going to group the people. And what else? Click on this. Costing is what? Cost allocation. Cost allocation flux field. So cost allocation flux field is the one. And then competencies is struct. S-T-R-U-C-T. In fact, what happens on a vanilla implementation, this is more than sufficient now. You choose the 202 now. And registration code is United States. United States, the legislation code, choose the United States now. Since it's the US, it works very well now. Currency is USD. Find your tab. And then click on OK, by which we can now do it. Minimum age, 18, and then maximum age is 60, we can give it. It will now give you a warning if you employ people who is less than 18. Fine. If you employ veteran, it will now throw a warning. And click on OK. Click on yes. And that's it, fine. So we are given it. And then we are going to give a HR classification also. This is organization we add this HR classification also. So that what happens, we can very well create employees at this level now. So it's not some certifying now. So once when it's completed, it will be coming over here. Click on it. And then it will be HR class, HR organization. Put a tick mark on this and then commit. And that's it. Fine. The business group is now created. And you go there and say this. Now we are going to get a ledger now. So once when the business group is created, what happens? We have a profile which is associated with this. So we're going to give a profile now. Profiling is a must now. As and when the entities are created, we're going to give a profile now. Fine. Switch responsibility to sysadmin now. Press yes. And I'm switching the responsibility to system administrator. Here what happens? The navigation is profile and then go to systems. This is the navigation. And then there's already brought over here. Number one. If you press number one, it will be coming. And then I will now query for my responsibility. Query for my responsibility 01. And then I will now give a 01 responsibility. Respond plus 21 and go there, go to the profile, and then here I will now give what HR percentage, secure percentage, this is the profile, HR percentage, secure percentage, and then enter it. So we go inside now. So here site level profiles cannot be modified, so that's what is coming. And then you go there, and then HR security profile, I'm going to give a value of 01, and then I give a tab, so by which it is now completed. So you can now see a business group is coming, let's commit, it's not done. So the security profile for your responsibility is now given. Oh, I'm sorry.
What is it?
Zero one, and then your tab. commit binder node. So now what happens for the second responsibility also we are going, right? Press the F11 and then we go back on 01, how many responsibilities are there? You can see we have rooted only two responsibilities and 21 is there. And click on OK and then click on find, and then for this also we are going to give the business group. So we cannot modify it and then go there and then give this. It is 01, back tab, and that's it. So it will be coming over here now. So you know, so keep your cursor over there and then control plus commit and then we have done it. So the first profiling has been done. The first profiling has been done. Fine. For the business group, the profiling has been done. Now we go for ledger and then legality. Fine. So we'll now go on and get the ledger. Fine. So this has got a profile. HR security profile is a profile. Fine. Then ledger has also got a profile. So we have to give it. And then operating system unit has got a profile. Remember, the legal entity, the master org and child org do not have any profiling at all. So only these three elements, my business group, the ledger, and then what happened, the operating units has got a profiles. Now we go and then get the ledger. Now the next element we are going to create it now. So the profiling for the both the responsibilities have been completed, and close it, and then we switch responsibility back to our responsibility, Alt F and then W, and then we know switch responsibility to our responsibility, Dishu, that's it, we are already in the responsibility here, go there, and then here I go to GL, right? Yes, F A A. We'll now open up the accounting setup manager now. So the navigation is what? I'm gonna show you the navigation now. Fine, this is the navigation. Fine. It's what? The navigation is set up. Financials, accounting setup manager, accounting setup, the navigation. So it's a web enabled form. You go there, come over here. So here, if you see, the first activity is what? We have to go and then create what? Yeah, legal entity first. The legal entity has to be created first, then after the ledger next. Fine. Legal entity first and then ledger next. And first of all, you get the legal entity. You go there and then the legal entity. So go there and then let's create the legal entity. So here we will now go there and then create a legal entity. Accounting setup manager. Go to legal entity tab region. Click on the legal entity tab region and then we are now going to legal entity. So click on this. We are now going to go there. It will now go over here. Swing cricket. It will now come over here now. Click on it. That's come over there. There. We have to move it like that. Now it has come over here, and you know, so let us go and then create a legal entity. Create legal entity is an indication. Click on create legal entity. So legal entities will be having certain things which will be done by the HR department. So HR is going to interact with the government actually. Fine. This is also known as a government reporting entity. So go there. It is 01 underscore legal underscore entity. And then it will be having a name also, 01 underscore legal org. I am putting it now. So in fact, this is what happens. You have to identify all these things now. Fine. I will now go there. 01 underscore legal underscore identifier. They will be having a TIN number 12345678900. Fine. This is a registration number. And then let me create a new address. Fine. Click on the create new address. So I will now create a new address for the legal entity. So the legal entity is basically an organization which will be residing in a location. Fine. 01 underscore legal underscore ADDR. My address. Address line is one is what? ADDR. Go down. City is New York. New York, I'm putting it now. New York has got this thing. Thank you on the state now. So it's still coming. Fine. So city is New York. I'm choosing the New York now. Ooh, I have given Val Pharma. Val Pharma than I get. So click on the state. State is NY. And zip code is 10020. Hey, come on. And then the county is New York actually. If you tap, the county will be coming as New York now. County has to come as New York. No bother. Fine, go there. It's New York. And then the remaining are not basically not much of everything is required. And then if you complete the creation of a legal address and then go there, and then you can even give the general information on these things. And then finally, what happens, you can submit it now. Fine. So this is more than sufficient. There are even more information that are required. Place of registration, etc. Nothing is mandatory over here. No? Fine. We leave it as such. And then click on submit. Click on save and add another details or apply. So by applying it, what happens, your 01 legal entity org and identifier will be getting saved on the system now as such. No? So click on apply. So it is now going to be created. So we have completed creating of a legal entity now. Now we go for a ledger. So the next activity is to go and get a ledger now. The registration number already exists. Somebody has put this registration number. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, something like that. And then click on apply. Some kachamucha number I'm going to give it so that nobody would have given this number at all. So address code already exists, Bapre. How come legal entity address 1, I will not put it. Yaro 01 the click on apply. Click on apply. So the address code is over there. So I'm not putting address 1 over there now. I'm not sure that it's getting created or not. It is now working. So nothing should repeat as a time. Vandichi. Yes, successfully created this legal entity. The legal entity is now successfully created. Right. Now we go to the accounting setup manager and then we'll now create the ledger. Next we are going to create the ledger. So the next activity is click on create accounting setups. Create accounting setup is the one. So I'm going to create it now. It's a three-step process and then I will now click on next. First step, I'm not doing anything at all. Click on next now. Click on next. So I am into the second step now and dig an accounting representatives for the chart of accounts. So here what happens, I will now have the chart of accounts. So name I'm going to give first of all 01 underscore ledger. Find out the name. A in that spot. 01 underscore ledger. Find out the name. And then chart of accounts, there is one existing one OPE or operations accounting flex. I'm going to use it now. So we cannot create it. It's a big one in the financials actually. There are no way. And then we have one calendar readymadely available. I'm going to use the existing calendar now. So capital A CC. Fine. I'm going to put it as capital A CC. It's an accounting calendar which I'm going to use it now. So existing ones I'm going to use it now. So we don't have to, I'm using the month one. Fine. Currency is USD. I click on the currency. So I will not choose the currency over here now. Currency is what? USD. And then click on this subletted accounting method. There are plenty of methods there. Fine. It is accrual. A C C R E. Click on E. CC accrual. So this will be taught in the financials training about how to create the chart of accounts as well as your calendars, everything. I will now use something for Italy is coming. Okay. So it has got four C's now. One is chart of accounts, currency, calendar, and then convention, accounting convention. And this is what it is. Click on next. The ledger is going to be created. Click on next. And then finally what happens is now carefully review everything. Fine. Be careful and click on finish. Which what happens? The ledger is now created. So it is now, it'll be fine. A confirmation is coming, fine. You now go back to return to accounting setups. You have just saved it, but it is not completed. So we have not completed the ledger, but you only saved it, fine, return to accounting setups, and then we are going to do the process of completion as such. Now let me query my ledger now, and then let me complete it now. So the ledger which has been recently created, I'm going to query it now. So I will now click on the update accounting options on this one. No. Then if you go on and see here what happens, the reporting currencies, the balancing segments, etc., etc., is not enabled as such because this itself is not completed. So let us first of all complete it. So once when this is completed, the remaining will be enabled as such. Now I click on update. So only the ledger options has to be first of all completed. Go there. And then you know do this, all these things, let us stick it as well. Go there. I will not say star short name is 01 lid. And then the first ever open period is what? I will not say Jan-16. And the first ever is Jan-16. And Jan-16 is the first ever open period. The what is? And the number of future periods is okay, fine. What is? Go down. So we are using these things. And then nothing else is required. Fine. In this page, there are so many things are there that will be done by financials. Click on next now. It's a four-step process. I'm in the second step now. From 1 of 4, I'm now going to 2 of 4 now. So here there is one retained earnings account is very important. The owner is going to pump in funds, so that account has to be properly filled up. Just like exactly in Fusion, we have this now. Or from here, the Fusion has got award. So whatever the retained earnings account has to be given now. It's a 2 of 4 now. So we go there and then give this. This is a retained earnings account. The 01-. So we go there. லீகல் அண்ட் ரிசர்ச் அது எங்கேயே போயிடுச்சு somewhere some problem you go now I don't know how it has gone to the legal entity now so click on update accounting options again and then here click on this edit on this one legal ledger options I'm going to edit now so this I have given a lot 01 and then go there So it's not going to search for it, it's not loading the first ever period. Jan 16, I'm choosing it now. Fine, the remaining I'm not choosing anything. I will now click on the next. Click on the next. So it goes to the next screen here. What happens? I will now go on the new edit accounts. Click on it. It did come inside, so it has not come inside, but which one? The arrow mark actually. So 01000-3310. It is owner's equity actually. Right? That's very important. Account. And then that is must. So that I have taken from Vishan, the existing there, and I'm taking it now. Right? I go there, it's not coming. Click on next. The 204 is now completed. I go for the 3 or 4 now. So I go for the 3 or 4 now. So in 3 or 4 nothing is required. Only financials has to do everything. Right? Click on next. Now our ledger is now going to be completed. Fine, click on finish by which what happens the ledger gets completed. So once the ledger gets completed, what happens? The remaining options will now become enabled now so that you can edit everything. The remaining options will be enabled. So you go the you can now see. Now reporting currency, you click on it. It is not yet started now. You can see not started. Click on this update icon. It's getting started. So go there and then do it now. Now, what happens? You go back on this now. Click on this return to accounting setup options. You're going over there now. Return to accounting setup options. Go back one level. And then you will again come back to this now. Reporting currencies on this now. You're going to do this now. So if you go down here, what happens? This reporting currencies is not started. So click on the update icon. Right, click on the update icon. And then we're not coming to point. Here, simply click on complete. That's more than sufficient. Really, what happens? They'll be adding all those things. So if I click on complete now. It's not completed. And then go down. And then here the next one tick mark is on. Now what happens? The balances you can click on it. Whereas the financials will be doing each and everything. Right, we simply complete it. Right, click on complete now. That's it. Click on complete. முஞ்சு போச்சு அண்ட் கோ டவுன் அந்த மாதிரி வடக்கு நோ சீரியஸ் தான் அண்ட் கோ டவுன் அந்த சீரியஸ் ஸோ வி ஆர் நவ கோயிங் டு கோ ஃபார் தி சீக்வன்சிங் கிளிக் ஆன் திஸ் நோ சீக்வன்சிங் இன் சீக்வன்சிங் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் யூ வில் பி ஹேவிங் எ ஸ்மால் சேஞ்ச் ஹியர் And the sequencing details is now coming up. Here there is a small change. There is no complete button directly coming. You drop down and then make it as a complete and then apply. And that's the only difference. In fact, you have to do all the setups actually. In financials, they do it. So I'm now making it as a complete and then applying it. So by which it gets applied. And then if you see the diagram, if you see this diagram, what happens? You have to have the legal entity ready. Rather, the legal entity must be ready with the ledger. Ledger legal entity. If legal entity is not ready, we cannot get the operating unit at all. So we will now add the legal entity to the ledger now. We had to add the legal entity to the ledger. Then only what happened, the operating unit will be coming. So that is what is. So we go there. And then you can now see the operating unit part is not coming over here at all. So let me add the legal entity, the operating unit will be coming. The remaining are tick marks. Fine. Click on add legal entity. And then let me add the legal entity over here now. So legal entity has been added. And click on add legal entity. I will now query my legal entity over here now. Fine. 01. Fine. Issue. It will now show you. Select it and then what happens, click on select. It comes over here now. And then click on apply. Fine, will now come. I click on apply. So that gets added. So the moment you add the legal entity to your ledger, what happens, the operating unit part will be coming up now. Click on apply. And go there. You will come. Fine, the legal entity has come now. So in your ledger, the legal entity is coming. You can now see operating unit. Vandichi. Fine, it's not done. Fine. Here, what happens, you go there and then simply complete it. We will now do the operating unit from our side now. நம்ம சப்ளை செயின் சைட் வில் நம்ம மெட்டல் கம்பெனி. ஆப்ரேட்டிங் யூனிட் ஹஸ் காட் 5 மாடியூல்ஸ் டு பி ஆப்ரேட்டட் அப்பான். சோ இஃப் யூ சீ என்னோட the operating unit has got 5 models here. It works on order management and then AR, OM AR, that's called order to cash life cycle, and then POT AP is a procure to pay life cycle, and then cash management. So these are the 5 models which operate the operating unit level. We will be setting up the operating unit level from a supply chain perspective as well, and you can do it done here also. So you go there, and then now what happens, this is what is now, everything is now ready. Now without completing it, we cannot do the profiling. If you don't complete it, we cannot get the profiling. So once when all the tick marks have come out here, what happens, you click on complete, and then once when you complete, there are certain things on the setups that cannot be modified at all. So the financial streams know very well, it has no mind. So click on complete. So by which, what happens, the ledger is now complete. Ledger legal entity combination is now complete. Click on complete. So we got completed now, right? So it's now giving accounting options also. So we are going to complete it now. I don't know why it is not got completed. Test code for completion now. Still saying loading, loading, loading. So once when it is completed, we have to do the profiling for all the responsibilities basically. All the responsibilities we have to give it now. Must be completed before you are doing it. That's what it is saying. But I am going to complete only, no? I don't know what's wrong. So warning, now it is not giving. You are about to complete your accounting setups. Fine. There are some things, if you make a change, what happens, nothing can be done. Die, pantama, venama, abdin kekudu. Fine. Okay, so you yes, so that upper mass, the changes na pannam kekudu. You cannot do anything at all. So you must be doubly sure upon confirming it. Practical yes. I've done it now. So by which what happens, it is now completed. So it will not throw a message that what happens, your accounting setup manager is now complete. Confirmation message has come, you have just completed this thing. Pachcha kalari chingu chao. Now we go there and then fill up the profilings basically. The profiling has to be completed now. So we go there and we get the profiling over here now. Fine, close it. Accounting setup manager is not complete. Fine, you go there and we get the profilings. So switch responsibility to Alt+F and then Alt+F is file menu will drop now. Fine, Alt+F, the file menu will drop and then go to W. Fine, switch responsibility. And then here all the responsibilities are coming plus yes, it will not go to sysadmin now. So once when you go into sysadmin, what happens, we go to the profile systems that is there in the top 10 list plus number 1. Number 1 will automatically execute that now. And number 1 is going to execute it now. You go there and we will be getting it now. Alt+F and the W. Yeah. And then the responsibility is what? Click on it. And then you will be having a love icon. Fine, 01 and then go there. The home-go-bit-love, the period love. And then here what happens, we will be having this GL percentage, set percentage. Fine, then the profile which you are going to say, GL percentage, set percentage. It is GL data access set. So we are going to give it for both the responsibilities. Fine, click on it and then 01 and then give a tab. Your ledger will be coming. Fine, save it now. Go back one level. F11 is going back one level. And then choose the next one now. Fine, 01 and then give a tab. This 21 is going to come up now. Pointing it properly or not for your responsibilities. Go there. It is now pointing properly. And the first one also, I don't make a check now. Fine, go there and then make a check of this one. So 01 percentage 1, I'm going to give it now. And the responsibility, I'm going to choose it. I will now remove the site level profiles. It will not show me. If I click on fine, it will not show you directly. So this is also okay. HR security profile for the both the responsibilities now set. Fine, go there. And then we'll now have a look at it now. So the business group is created, ledger is created, legal entity is created. The profiling for both the responsibilities for business group is now done. And then the profiling for the ledger for both the responsibilities now, it is now completed and the profiling has been completed. Now we go for the operating unit creation. The next step is the OU creation now. Fine, go there and then let us go there and then do this now. Fine, switch responsibility to operating unit one. Fine, you go there and then go to the operating unit now. So here we will now go on and go on again. Fine, you go to inventory and then SO enter. Fine, yes. You go to inventory and then go to SO enter. And then we'll now go on and get a new R operating unit. Fine, click on O, new. Yes, O enter will now take you on this one. And 0 under the inventory. Remember, it is OPE underscore unit. And and then go there. Type is an operating unit. Operating in the type. And you go there and give it. Location is what? 01 and give a tab and then commit. 01 Mayapur is the location fine. You can now see when the other legal addresses have also come now fine. Classified is the inventory or not sorry. Classified is an operating unit. Classify this is an operating unit. It's an operating unit. Click on it, select it, and then click on OK. And then enable it and then save. I click on others now. And there are three informations which I have to give. One is an accounting information. Sorry, operating unit. Operating information is an important one. Click on it. So this operating unit reports to what? Operating unit reports to this legal entity, this ledger. Fine. It's going to say we are going to report to what else. And then click on enter again. Once when you enter in, it will be opening it up now. And then the primary ledger is what? 01 and then give a tab. The short name is coming over here, full name is coming on the right hand side. And then this ledger is what? 01 ledger. And then we can even give a short code for the financial teams to make reporting basically. And short code, OT underscore code. And then dishum, that's it. Fine, by which whatever the operating unit is not completed. Now the profiling has to be done. Fine, close it now. Switch responsibility to again system administrator now. We go to system administrator. And then here, you go there and then give the profiling. The profiling will be given now. So go to number one, profile. Profile system values.
Okay.
So here, I will now put the first responsibility. Find the first responsibility. I'm going to put it. The profile is what? MO percentage, OPE percentage. That is the profile entry. So we go and then enter this profile. So click on it. And then here we are going to put our 01. Go there and then commit. Save it. Upon every entry, you have to save it and then see in the bottom where the transaction is completed or not. Press the F11 and then come back on 11 and then choose the second one. Your control of 11 execute query. F11 is enter query mode, control of 11 is execute query. And then click on find now. And then here again the same operating unit has to be given now. Fine, click on it. ரெண்டு தான் போட்டிருக்கேன் And then go to request. It is equal to scheduled process of fusion now. You request and then what happens? Either mother got the angle pono, talagida varying, submit new request and then be okay. So to come to this page navigation, what happens? The keyboard shortcut now, fine, close it, I will not bring it to the keyboard shortcut. Fine. Keyboard shortcut, I'm going to do it, fine. It is Alt VR, Alt N, Enter, G, Boom, Bar, it will come.
Alt VR.
Alternate kind of orders.
Oh God.
RTO. Net is over there. Fine. With Alt V. You request fine. It has to come now. It's not coming at all. Window. Navigator is there. How come this is not coming? I close it. Because we have to get that now. Close for the one no. File menu now. Alt F. File menu. W switch response and it's not coming. So close for the there is the last one actually. கொஞ்சம் நெட் ஸ்பீட் கொஞ்சம் உதகுது அதனால தான் அது என்ட்ரஸ்ட்
எப்படி
லிங்க் பண்ற
சிஸ்டம் அட்மினிஸ்ட்ரேட்டர் போயிட்டு
And then I'm going to go for a new request. Fine. Alt-N is a new request. Alt-N is new request. And then what happens if you give a enter, it will be going over there. Alt-N, and then click on enter, when the cursor is already on OK, it will be coming. So this I will not show you, but how do we pass? Control-F4 is close the form now. Control-F4 is close the form. So let me close the form. Close the form. Close the form. Now you see, I'm not going to go fast now. Fine. Alt-VR, Alt-N, enter. Hey, come on. It has to go there.
Alt-N,
enter. So by which what happens, we will now go into the new request. So I will now go for reply. Reply, and then what happens, we are going to go for the call now. The contract. Yeah, scheduled process is called replicate C data. Reply and then give a tab. In the morning, I'm official over muscle over there. So I am now in the wrong place, so it's not coming. Cancel it. And if you go to sysadmin, I had to be in sysadmin. Not as a responsibility. So let me go to sysadmin and then run it. The company must be running sysadmin. So go to sysadmin and then run it now. So I am in sysadmin and Alt-VR, Alt-N, enter. Reply and then give a tap. And then give a tap, it will be coming. இந்த மாதிரி பாதி எழுதி அடிச்சா வருமாங்க வராது வரும் அது ரொம்ப லேட்டா வரும் அது சம்டைம்ஸ் வரும் சம்டைம்ஸ் வராது முடிக்கும் அந்த மாதிரி பாசிங் திஸ் பாயிண்ட் ஓகே அந்த நம்ம சப்மிட் தி கான்ட்ராக்ட் ஃபைன் சப்மிட் தி கான்ட்ராக்ட் இஸ் ஆல் டைம் ஈஸியா இருக்கும் அது கிவ் டேப் அண்ட் தென் சே நோ டு திஸ் நவ ஃபைன் தி ஆக்டிவிட்டிஸ் நவ கம்ப்ளீட் ஃபைன் கிளிக் ஆன் ஃபைன் நவ அது அதுக்கு அதான் சொல்ல மாட்டாங்க அது ரொம்ப பெரிய விஷயம் அது It is basically a database enhancement. It is going to add an org ID column in all the transaction tables of your operating unit. So there are two types of tables. One is a non-transaction table, one is a transaction table. So on all the transaction tables, this replicate C data is going to add an org ID column. Right? The list, you can ask Sundar. Sundar will explain me everything. I close it. Because I don't have time to explain all these things now. I close it. So this is what us. No, I'm just throwing them. அப்புறம் 11th ஸ்டெப் இஸ் நவ் கம்ப்ளீட்டட் நவ் வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் வி ஹேவ் டு கோ அண்ட் தென் கிரியேட் அ கேலண்டர் ஐ வில் நாட் பி கிரியேட்டிங் எ கேலண்டர் நவ் பிகாஸ் வி ஆர் நாட் ரன்னிங் இன்வென்டரி அசெட்ஸ் நவ் ஐ வில் நவ் யூஸ் விஷன்ஸ் கேலண்டர் இட்செல்ஃப் விஷன் 01 ஐ அம் கோயிங் டு யூஸ் இட் நவ் அண்ட் தென் ஐ வில் நவ் கிரியேட் அ மாஸ்டர் ஆர்க் அண்ட் சைல்ட் ஆர்க் சிமிலர் டு வாட் ஹேப்பன்ஸ் யுவர் ஃபியூஷன் நவ் லெட்ஸ் கிரியேட் அ மாஸ்டர் ஆர்க் அண்ட் சைல்ட் ஆர்க் 13th ஸ்டெப் ஐ அம் இன் அண்ட் யூ கோ தேர் அண்ட் தென் லெட் மீ ஸ்விட்ச் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி கம் பேக் டு மை ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி ஸ்விட்ச் ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி அண்ட் கம் பேக் டு மை ரெஸ்பான்சிபிலிட்டி ஆஃப் 01 அண்ட் தென் லெட் மீ கோ அண்ட் கிரியேட் அன் ஆர்கனைசேஷன் Open up the inventory now. I will now open up the inventory. Go to inventory. Go down and then go to the inventory now. Now 10 minutes are good. Fine, go to the inventory. And then here, what is this test inventory? Set up. And then go to org. And then I'm going to get org. Set up org. Org is a navigation which what happens. I'll be creating a new inventory org. Set up org. So go to alt A. is a new R I'm going to create now. Oh, and then here, Alt-A, a new R. Oh. And then here, what happens, I'm going to say 01 underscore IMO1. This will be of a type plant. Plant, and then you tap. And then choose the same location, whereas this same location is not possible in the infusion, you cannot give it. Here it's possible. What are transactions? I'm going to give it. Request is going to give it. One location, request is going to give it. Request is going to give it. Requisition to be going to give it. So we should not do it from a supply chain perspective. It's, if you give it, it's not work at all. It is like what? Can you put a bomb in the India Madras airport? You can very well do it, but you are not supposed to do it. So similarly, whatever the infusion also, you can very well give it, but it will not work at all. Here it will work. Now here, whatever I am going to say, what is the primary ledger? 01 and then give a tab. The ledger is coming. And then the legal is also coming because there is a ledger. And then I will now say 01. And then this is how the reporting is going to be. You see this now, the reporting is going to be. So the item master organization is now going to report via this structure. This operating unit, this legal entity, and then this ledger. Purita? Fine. You're now given everything. Click on OK. Zero on ledger. Click on OK. And then click on OK. And then click on Yes. click on okay and then click on yes. So by which it is now completed. So go to others now. And then go to the inventory information. So customer supplier association is not required, that is taken care of by the financials now. Accounting, inventory and receiving are the very important one. You go to the inventory information, go to click on okay. Now here, so now for the first org, we had to enter all the informations manually. If you go to the costing, you'll be having plenty of accounts. And then if you go to the other accounts, you'll be having everything. But since it's a training, I'm going to copy it from an existing org and go there. Let me copy it.
Okay.
I go to tools. I'm in the main platform. Go to tools and go to copy organization. Let me copy from an existing organization. Now press V. Everything starting on V will be coming. Don't click anything inside and then click press V. It will be going over there. Vision operations. And then click on OK. They are not choosing it. From vision operations, all the parameters are copied over here now. So I'm going to give R code now. The R code will be given over here. And it is 011. And then click on the master organization. Master organization is what? 01 and then give a tab. The same R will be the master. Just like Infusion. Just like Infusion. Whatever. The same R will be the master. I'm using the version 01 character itself. The remaining accounts are already compiled. And then what happens? Make the locator control determinant subunit level. This is a very important synapse. And then save. Save is control S. Give a control S save. By which what happens? This gets saved. You can see the what happens. Now it is now giving you a note. Ignore the note. This is only for the manufacturing actually. The costing method cannot be changed. Click on OK now. So you can now see this now. You can see it. Maximize and see this. So this now happens. Close it. And then go to others now. And then you go to the receiving information. Inventory is not complete, I go to the receiving information. Okay. So this is again a been able to form. This is also exactly similar to what you have seen in Fusion now. So this is the organization. So for which what happens, I will now say, this receipt days yearly is 1, this is 2, this is 3. I'm now giving the mandatory information over here now. This is an account of the mandatory information. 01001410-40. So we don't have a ticker of it. And then here go there and then go this now. I will come to that a bit later now.
Fine. Okay, fine. We can have
so receiving inventory account, trading account. So these are the important ones. I will now give 1000 as a start number.
Okay.
So all the star marked ones are important. Then click on save by which one of the receiving information for the master order is not complete. Even though we don't transact anything on the master, this is a must because supply creation will give a problem if you don't give it now. Click on save. So it's not done. So a confirmation has come up. So let us go on and similarly, in second inventory hour, there is a child inventory hour. So go there. Control down arrow is for the creation of a new record. You keep your cursor on the name. Control and down arrow, a new record will be created. Find 01 underscore. 01 underscore. INV2. This is also what I planned. Sulba. So we go there. And then here, what happens? I'll give a location 01 and then give a tab and then save it now. 01 commit. Save it. At this stage you have to commit, remember. Then only you have to go on and play your classification, otherwise it will now cutify. Go there and then go and then classify the inventory or enable it and then commit and then go to others now. Enable and then go to and then save it. First time give name, type and location same and then afterwards classification, enable and then save. Click on others now. And then go to the accounting information.
How is going
to
account?
01 and then give time.
So which instance?
Operating unit is 01 operating unit correct. So now we are given this now point, click on OK. And then click on OK and then click on S by which whatever is now completed. And then go to others and then give the inventory information. So this is the inventory information which I am giving now. So here for this one I will now copy from my master because since the master is already ready. The master is ready. What happens? The child will be copied from master. The child will be copied from master. So you go there, go to tools, and then go to copy organization. This time, previously I copied from Vision, now I'm going to copy from my master. From my master, I'm going to copy it now. So tools, copy organization, you can now see it will be coming in the top now. Because 01 in the top. So choose this and then click on OK, by which one happens, it's completed. And then the organization goes on 012, 011 or the one. So this also is going to have the same master. So master will also have the same master, child will also have the same master. And then save it. Which program is now complete. Upon every commit, always observe in the bottom whether the transaction is complete or not. Let's close it now. And then what happens, you go to others, and then go to the receiving information. In the last part of this today's training now, click on OK. Go there. So it is again a web enabled form. we give all the mandatory bills over here now and then save it now and go there. 1.3, the mandatory informations. You go there, control issue, and go there and then give these accounts. These two accounts, you can just give it and then make the start as 2000. And then click on save, by which what happened, the receiving information is also completed. So we have completed the enterprise structure creation on this one. The enterprise is now completely created. So in the next class, we will now go ahead on this one. We'll now go on then 15, 16, 17, 18 are HRM setups now. So that we'll be learning it. And then afterwards you go ahead. So this is Nana, then if you have any clarifications, you can write to me at apps.nana@iappsconsulting.com. Thank you for watching this video and seeing the next session. Bye.